Hello guys, in this video we'll be learning about origin of the Earth. In the galactic park, helium and hydrogen atom dotted the universe with atomic clouds. Small pockets of the gas had enough gravity to cause atom to collect, right? Now the presence of atomic clouds and they are rotating, right? They start forming a disc-shaped structure because of the gravitational attraction. Because of the gravitational compression, collision, heat is generated here, right? Because at this point there is lots of collision. This heat soon starts the fusion reaction, right? That is generation of further heat. Protosun formation starts. The hydrogen nuclei fused to form new helium. Right, this protosun heated the solar nebula, especially the inner nebula. Right, the inner nebula was heated. Now, soon the hydrogen converts to helium because of the nuclear fission. So, fission, then fusion. It releases further energy and the sun was born, right? Now, a phase comes that due to huge heat, T Tauri phase, where very strong solar winds, swept most of the remaining gas and particles. So any particle less than 10 meters of size was swept away far, right? And now, because you know the inner solar nebula, because of its proximity to the sun, was very hot, the only material which remained on these were the refractory materials, the iron and the rocky silicates, which were very stable. They remained here. But because it was very hot, the volatile gases blew away, right? The volatile gases blew away, and the planets which were out, that is outer solar nebula, these planets were not very hot. So, since these were not very hot, we see that the volatile gases which dominate in the first four terrestrial planets, the volatile gases which blew away, right? The volatile gases are dominant in the Jovian planets, and because it was not so hot, right? So hydrogen, helium, methane and ammonia dominates these planets, the outer solar nebular planets, right? And here we find iron and rocky silicates, which were stable, right? Next, we come to a very important topic of differentiation of Earth. Earth was a barren planet. Because of radioactive decay, because of the gravitational compression, because of the meteoritic impact, lots of heat generated, and a barren planet converted to a hot, heated planet, right? Now the constituents of the Earth melted. Iron melted before silica because iron had less melting point. Moreover, iron being heavier than the silica, it started sinking towards the core. Because you see, iron is 26 and silica is 19. So silica rich material were naturally forced up because it was replaced by the iron. And when it came to the top, it was known as the magma ocean. So if you see now, the core is rich in iron and nickel, right? But the upper part, that is the crust, is rich in silica and other lighter elements like potassium, sodium, aluminium. And if you see, the middle mantle, it's rich in iron oxide and magnesium oxide because these are relatively heavier than these. So after the initial segregation starts the secondary segregation, that in core itself the outer core tends to be more silica rich and liquid, but the inner core tends to be more iron and nickel rich, right? Knife. And this is solid because of extreme pressure. The mantle again differentiates. The outer mantle is more potassium and sodium rich silicate, but the inner mantle is more iron and magnesium rich silicate because of their heaviness. After partial melting and differentiation, vapors and gases comes out. CO2, CO, N2, H2, hydrogen chloride, SOX, NOX and H2O was evolved from the Earth's interior. The hydrogen combined with oxygen and lots of vapors, it condensed in atmosphere and it rained. Water acquired from the comets which were colliding also helped a lot in enriching the oceans. It is estimated that 15 million small comets attacked or were attacking the Earth every year. So you can imagine every small comet the size of a big house, right, having great amount of water, right? Finally is the interior of the Earth. As I've already told, the Earth can be divided into on the basis of two parts. Compositionally, it's crust, mantle and core, and mechanically it can be divided on the basis of how they behave on the application of pressure, right? So lithosphere, asthenosphere, mesosphere, outer core and inner core. The core has lots of nickel and iron. The mantle has the silicon oxide less than 45%, but a lot of iron oxide and magnesium oxide. The crust has the SiO2 more than 50%, lots of potassium oxide, sodium and aluminium, but very few MgO and FeO, right? Now lithosphere is solid, asthenosphere acts like a butter, semi-solid, mesosphere is solid, outer core is liquid but the inner core is solid, right? So the crust, it's again divided into two parts, the continental crust and the oceanic crust. The crust, the thickness is from 5 to 80 kilometers. Definitely continental crust is thicker, right? The mantle is somewhere around 2500 to 2900 kilometers and the core is at from 2500 kilometers to 6400 kilometers. The lithosphere, it covers some parts of mantle also, so 100 kilometers. Asthenosphere is somewhere about 600 kilometers. The outer core ends at 50 kilometers, right? So that was some stats. Mineralogical changes is there between oceanic crust and continental crust, as we saw earlier. So compositionally, oceanic crust is around 50% of SiO2. Continental crust has more SiO2, and I think you can understand that. It has oceanic crust has more of heavier minerals like Mg and FeO. Continental crust like Na2O, K2O, Si and Al. Since heavy minerals, these are heavy and the density is somewhere between 2.9 to 3.1 gram per centimeter cube. It's lighter and the density is like 2.6 to 2.9 gram per centimeter cube. As far as the thickness is concerned, the oceanic crust is thin, the continental crust is thicker. The elevation, it has low surface elevation, right? But the elevation of continental crust is very high. I mean to say, if any oceanic crust is there and from that 0 point to maximum point, the elevation is low, right? Age, the maximum oceanic crust age you can find is of 180 million years, and this is because oceanic plates are constantly under subduction, so they are destroyed and they are recreated. But as far as the continental crust is concerned, the oldest has been found somewhere between 3 billion years old. So that's all. So we discussed origin of the Earth, right? We discussed the differentiation of the Earth and how the different layers of the Earth form. Then we discussed the interior of the Earth. And finally, we discussed about the difference between crust, the continental crust, and oceanic crust. Thank you.